Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this session, we are going to see about how to use your paginated reports inside your Power BI desktop. What do you mean by that? You have created a Power BI paginated reports and you have deployed in your Power BI services. Either you can use these reports as a separate paginated reports if you want. And there may be some cases, some reports need to be used along with your Power BI reports. How to use that? Let us try to walk you through in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. Let's try to open Power BI desktop. And if you are following my channel, we have a separate playlist for how you can create your Power BI paginated reports. You can go and use that one. So now we have this report. Let's try to get our data. Let me get the data from Power BI datasets itself. You can use any of the Excel or whatever may be the case. I already deployed this using, from this data set. So I will go for it. So it can be any of the data set, right? So now what I need, I can build any report here. You might aware how you can create using Power BI reports. You can create, right, using different fields over here. But this video focusing mainly on how you can create the paginated reports, right? So let us try to create simple report, and I will try to explain why I'm creating all this stuff, right? So this is my report using Power BI desktop. There is quantity and sales amount. I want something with some filter. Let us go for product name here. This product name wise, I need some quantity. Okay, let us try to have it as a chart over here and slightly increase the sizes so that people can view it properly. And this is the label. Let me increase it. This is again the label. There you go. Okay, it is somewhat better now. Now, where I can add the paginated reports. So it is under visualization. So what we can do is, like, before adding, let me add a background. So this is the paginated report visualization. So in order to add a paginated report along with your Power BI desktop reports, you need to add it as a visual, another visual in your Power BI desktop. So once you have this paginated reports, you need to get it from your paginated report services, meaning like Power BI services. So for Power BI services, you need to have it in a premium per user capacity, I mean premium workspace, right? And either you should have a pro or premium per user licensing or premium per capacity, whatever. So once you do that, right, so these are the different paginated reports available in the workspace that this user can have access to. First, I do not have any parameters from this report, just go by first paginated reports. Okay, then if you have a parameters, you can click on set parameters, but this particular report doesn't have any parameters, so it will not prompt you anything over here. Okay, so there is no parameters for this report. Click see report to proceed. That's it. So basically, like, what we are doing, so this is Power BI desktop report, and inside that you can able to view your paginated reports, and there is no interactivity between these two reports because this is not acting or reading any of the parameters, right? That is what this particular, this is acting as a static report, okay? Out of different reports that we have deployed, let me walk you through over here in the Paginated reports workspace. Here you can see this icon indicates a paginated reports. This doesn't have any parameters, just a report. So you are seeing your Power BI desktop report along with your paginated reports in the same page. Okay, in this cases you can go for it. In another scenario, I want to showcase another scenario where this is another paginated reports, where when I click on it, it will prompt me for the parameter. That is, I need to choose sub parameter here that will filter, right? If you see Jeans Levis, and when you click on view report, this will give me some sub report. This is I have done in my previous video. It's very simple report. Just it will show me in Jeans Levis I have 6 quantity and online quantity is 6. You can choose some other product name here, then it will give me what are the online or order shop. So this report you have generated. Now what is the scenario is like, when you click on the product name from the Power BI desktop report, that will be passed to your paginated reports deployed in this server. Instead of choosing it, this value should be passed from the Power BI report values, right? How you can do that, right? This is the next scenario I'm going to show. So this report doesn't have any parameters, so there is no interactivity. Now you can go and edit it, like you can choose or change any of the reports. Now so you are choosing this sub report. Now you go to set reports. So now what you need to do, you need to choose from a column, right? What columns are passed to this parameter. So in my case, this particular column has to be passed. Once you choose, unless you choose any field, this will be grayed out. You need to choose a field here. So this will start appearing. So product name, whatever you choose, that will start appearing. Then click on see report. Now no products are selected. Once you click on, okay, once you click on, that will be taken as first of product name, obviously. Once you click on any one of the product name, this value that is from the Power BI desktop is passed to your sub report. You see, you need to apply changes each time because that report acting differently. As soon as you click on it, it will not immediately reflect here. You see, these values are reflecting immediately 126075, but it is requesting you apply changes or not. Okay, so once you click on it, you can see this report changes dynamically. The first case, whatever we see is like, that is static report without any parameters, you can do it. But when you want to pass some of the filters that can be applied to your paginated reports, that is also possible here. I hope you understand the concept between how you can use the paginated reports as part of the Power BI desktop reports. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.